If we talk about the airport itself, I think definitely, I think we will have bring your own device, which has started. So we are developing that in many airports. We're deploying that. So basically, you will have lots of, most of the documentation. You will have an advance approval from the government. So we are working with governments. We are working with the governor of Abu Dhabi and Dubai. So basically with the Emirates to have what we call the advanced passenger processing. So basically you will have a health status implement travel corridor. So people will have a safer traveler there. Most important as well is what we call, we'll see more and more, you will use your face as your boarding pass. So basically using biometrics, mobile technologies. So what we call Incita Smart Pass. We have developed that into many airports. So basically you can just, it take you a few seconds to enroll using your face, as I said, as your boarding pass. And then you can through from the check-in to the gates, to the lounge, to the arrival also process. So that's really an important aspect. As I say, also we're moving, you will see more as well services from what we call the face pod. So when you use this biometrics, so face pods now are being what we call mask aware. So touch points invite passengers to remove their mask if needed. A new biometric facial recognition engine is to improve accuracy, what we call in the periocular area around the individual eyes. So also we are developing that. But most important, we're not trying to have a huge investment on the airport or infrastructure, because we believe we can reoperate some of them. And while using the QR code or using the existing kiosk, you can use your mobile as remote control, just access to any Wi-Fi, and then use it remotely without really touching the kiosk. So that's really helping us to ensure we don't reinvent the entire infrastructure at any airport. Also, other aspects.
Before we let you go, I just want to quickly ask you, sorry about that. Just before we let you go, I want to ask you in terms of these corridors, these safety corridors that are already being set up, for example, in Singapore and in the Southeast Asia region. How quickly do you think here in the Middle East, given the need of most folks here in the Gulf Arab countries to travel, whether they be analysts from McKinsey or Booz or elsewhere, how difficult or how quickly do you think that these GCC airlines and governments are going to come together and find some sort of way forward on a travel corridor? Because it seems as if that's part and parcel with this.
Hadi, it's basically we started some proof of concept with many airports in the Middle East. It's not going to be difficult. The importance is to have really between different stakeholders at the airport, between government, between airlines and airport authorities, to ensure we have a seamless understanding of the entire process. We have started that. I think with the existing infrastructure, it could be as quickly, but it definitely would require 3 to 6 months minimum to ensure we have the right infrastructure. But we have already enabled most of the airport in the region, so that shouldn't be an issue.